Good morning, YZ. Today is November 30th. I'm Joe Kotke.
I'm Ethan Kleinheit.
And I'm Kelsey Deering. An Army veteran has recently come forward with additional sexual allegations against Minnesota Senator Al Franken, claiming he groped her during her deployment in Kuwait. Stephanie Kaplan, now 41, was 24 at the time of the incident. Franken was visiting the American troops while she was stationed in the Middle East. During a photo op with the senator, Kaplan claimed she was touched inappropriately by Franken. Kaplan saying, quote, "When he put his arm around me, he groped my right breast. I remember I kept thinking, is he going to move his hand? Was it an accident? He never moved his hand." Kaplan is the fifth woman to accuse Franken of sexual misconduct. In other news, the domestic dispute at home turned quickly when Christopher Gaddis, 58, shot and killed his wife, daughter, and his daughter's boyfriend during a family dinner at their home in Virginia. Gaddis was charged with 3 counts of first-degree murder and 3 counts of a use of a firearm in the commission of a felony as of yesterday, according to NY Daily News. All 3 victims died of gunshot wounds. Gaddis is the youth pastor at the family's local church with no history of violent crimes. Police have yet to uncover a motive. Now back to the anchors.
Intramural basketball roster sheets are available in the activities office. They must be completed and turned in by December 5th. Games begin on December 19th. Register on ePay.
Student volunteers are desperately needed to serve as small group leaders for the 5th grade Meadow Ridge Kindness Retreat on Wednesday, December 6th. Please see Mrs. Badger in the Clubwise office if you can help out. This will be on a school day and an excused absence will come with it.
Hour of Code will be hosted in the Trojan Media Center on Friday, December 8th from 3:30 to 4:30. Activities will range from beginner to advanced. All students are invited and refreshments will be served. Now let's go over to weather with Maggie. Hey, Maggie.
Thanks, Ethan. Good morning, Wyzetta. This morning we woke up with temperatures around 35 degrees. It is currently 38 degrees, but it feels like 29. We'll reach our daytime high of 46 degrees around 3 p.m. today. It'll also be a windy one with gusts at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tomorrow we'll see highs back in the 50s. Thinking of taking a winter break in Hawaii? It's currently snowing in Mauna Kea, the highest volcano in Hawaii, according to Newsweek. The volcano has received 8 inches of snow in the last few days, and rain and snow is expected to fall throughout the rest of the week. Enjoy this night's stretch of weather, Wyzetta. Now back to the anchors.
Well, Lydia, it was nice to see you, and Maggie made that little appearance while Kelsey was talking about Franken.
Yeah, well, we're back. Girls hockey dominated Academy of Holy Angels on Tuesday night with a final score of 8-2. Junior Alexa Osell scored the first goal of the night with an assist from sophomore Sophie Urban. Their next game is tonight against Blake at 7. Dance team has their first competition of the season tonight at Hopkins. They will be competing with Jazz. Doors open at 6:30, so good luck to the girls. Girls basketball also plays tonight against Maple Grove at 7. Check in right here for updates on the scores tomorrow. In other sports news, Maya Moore of the WNBA Minnesota Lynx will be honored at this year's Sports Illustrated Sports Person of the Year Awards on December 5th. She has been named Performer of the Year. Joining her will be Joel Embiid of the Philadelphia 76ers and Carlos Beltran of the Houston Astros. Now back to the anchors.
Driver education for January is now open for registration. There will be 2 sessions from 3:20 to 6:20 p.m. or 6:30 to 9:30 p.m. Pick up a flyer in the 4 offices with the rest of the details.
There are only 2 spots left on the Costa Rica biology research trip. You can earn 3 college credits through going on this trip. The first 2 that register with teacher recommendations will be accepted. See Mrs. Leland if you are interested.
Club YAS volunteers are needed for a regional spelling bee on Saturday, December 16th from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Eisenhower Community Center in Hopkins. Full and half-day shifts are available. Stop by the Club YAS offices on the 2nd floor to sign up. Well, Scott, I'm really excited to see that new Alphabet Soup video, but for now, let's see what's going on in A&E.
All right. Good morning, Wyzetta. Auditions for the Competition One Act Eurydice will take place after school Monday, December 4th. Callbacks will take place on Wednesday, December 6th. If you plan on auditioning, please fill out the audition packet at whstheater.com before Monday. Auditions and callbacks for the freshman sophomore musical Little Shop of Horrors took place this past Tuesday and Wednesday. To all who audition, make sure to check the cast list on Saturday that will be posted on the WHS Theater website. In other news, films getting released this weekend are Wonder Wheel and The Disaster Artist, both only opening in select cities. The Disaster Artist is the long anticipated film based on the book that tells the story of how The Room was made. It will be playing at the Landmark Uptown Theater, and as a fan of the book, The Room, and the great amount of talent that star and director James Franco has put together for this film, you can expect me to be in attendance this weekend. And now let's go over to everybody's favorite part of the week.
juxtapose me?
No.
Kind of. That's that like one word in English that I never get right, and it's where you kind of like two things kind of like compare each other, but like really opposite. You know what I mean?
I've never heard of that word.
Never heard of that word.
A position on something? I have no idea.
No.
Do you know how to spell it? Do you want to try anyways?
I really don't know how to spell that.
Do I throw this down or just drop it?
J-U-X-T-P-O-S-I-T-O-N?
J-U-X-T-A-P-O-S-E? Juxtapose?
Do you know what the word juxtapose means?
I didn't.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Me and him got in a fight. Do you have any tips? He's still warm at me.
Just apologize. I guess.
It's like you two are like juxtapositioning each other.
Nice.
Sorry.
Fun in your English.
Fun in English. You know, I accept your apology.
That was very heartwarming. That's all we had for our show today. On behalf of the Wyzetta technical crew, Lydia Johnson and Maggie Reese, I'm Scott Larson.
I'm Joe Kotke.
And I'm Ethan Kleinite. Have a great day, Wyzetta.
Be here by myself. Who'd have thought that you'd be bad for my health? Now I know. Now I know I'm just a man on a wire. Oh. Who'd have thought about the cause and effect? Yesterday's love is now tomorrow's regret. Now I know. As long as the wind